Chatters, and welcome back to Cococraft Server! So here we are in our lovely room of storage. I hadn't actually had a name for it. Storage room, yeah. I need to put something there. I will, eventually. Do I have any white wool? I don't. That is a crying shame, is what that is. Crying, sad, shame, you know what? Whatever. Okay, so what I'm doing today, or at least I thought it would be nice to do today. No, I don't want that. Maybe I will think on that, actually. Okay, so what I'm going to do today is I need to light up, at least with a temporary type of light, that hill out there. So, yeah, this is going to be like a nice little city sort of block. I don't really... Yeah, that's dangerous looking. I'm going to have to do something about that. But in the meantime, no, I'm not going to axe stuff. I have torches! Hooray! So we're going to go ahead and do a lot of torching up of this area here. I thought it would be nice to also put, like, either glowstone or jack-o'-lanterns down underneath there. Oh my goodness! It suddenly occurred to me that October's tomorrow. No, not tomorrow. But soon. Like, imminently soon. Anyways, gonna get all this on here. All this on here. If, you know, little pieces of grass disappear, it's not a huge issue because, you know, it's easy to get grass back. Grass back, grass back. All right, so, how's everyone's week been? I went ahead and had some fun at a little convention. Got to play some games yesterday and the day before. And let me tell you, when you are going and playing games from 9 in the morning, actually slightly earlier is when you're supposed to be getting up, so it feels longer, until just after midnight, it wears on you. It does. Oh my goodness. It's just so... so exhausting, and especially when you're not really eating what you probably should be eating. You're like just eating chips and candy and stuff, and then your body feels like, what are you doing to me? Yeah, it happens. So, I'm still kind of recovering from that. I should probably drink like tea or something. Where, how did you get out here? Aren't you supposed to be in that other little pen? I'm so disappointed in you, chicken. I need to name the chicken. What? No! Stop! Stop! Okay. There we go. So, over here, and then here. Alright, so we're doing good. We're doing pretty darn good. The sun is coming up, unfortunately, though. I need to hurry up. Oh, no! I'm out of torches. Got more torches. I'm so sorry, guys, but I need to... I just need a ways. I don't need day. I need time set night. And then I'll turn it back to day. I promise. It's just for now. I need to be able to see. I know you're probably all waiting for daytime, and I sincerely apologize, but no, need that one. I just want to see what it is. I mean, I could look in F3 mode, but that's going to take a long time. And it's just as easy to say, hey, that looks kind of dark. Let's fill it in. All right, let's put it up here. And then here. I know. No one really wants to just watch me wander around and throw torches down. But anyways, yeah, I had fun at the little convention. It was great fun. For those of you who don't know, I play tabletop role-playing games, specifically Pathfinder. And occasionally I'll do, like, little... conventions, mainly right now because that's the only way I get to play the game, because we don't have any home games or store games near us. We just happen to move to a place that is kind of like bereft of those. So yeah, it's sad, but I like the area that we moved to. It's nice and chill. It's closer to church, so it works out best for us this way, and you can go on walks, and it's wonderful. That being said, I mean, we do make some sacrifices. Like, we only really get to play the tabletop role-playing game when it's convention time, and even that's like a drive of like 45 minutes, but it's worth it, you know? It just is. Okay, so let's actually put this up here And down here, I just want to make it have some light. Oh, hold on. Did you need something? Well, I'm sorry, but I'm kind of busy. Gosh. It's so needy. Spiders are needy. Maybe that should be like some sort of tweet. Hashtag needy spiders. I don't think that's actually going to be a hashtag. I just like saying the word because it reminds me of hash browns. And that in turn reminds me of potatoes. And I love potatoes. Okay, so that hill is quite thoroughly lit up. Now I just have to figure out what to do with it. If anyone has any suggestions, comment section down below. That's what it's for. Anyways, so I think I might have a few stacks, maybe at least one stack of emeralds, so I can figure out what I want to do with this. Huh. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and grab... No, you know what? Maybe I should just go ahead and grab the clay and stuff, and then we could figure out from here, because this is going to be the elevator, or at least part of the elevator shaft. I have so many elevators in this place, it's ridiculous. And then... Because, I don't know, I mean, I think it would be nice to have, like, a wall. So this would be, like, an emerald wall, and when we could have, like, some sort of archway. Archway. And maybe we could have Emerald City House or what have you. And then the archway would come out this way. Not the archway, but the wall. And let's see here. Come out here. I don't know how far I want the wall to go, honestly. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe out to here? Like right around there? Because, I mean, I can totally expand my grounds. I don't recall how big my... Oh my gosh, that's so cute! They've got like... Oh, I thought it was going to be like bushes. Like pretending to be bushes. This is really cool. I don't recall who's building this. I know that's Whittle's house up there. Who's someone who's fairly... I guess new? I don't really know. Got some armor stands in there. Why is this... Oh, someone's been harvesting jungle wood. There's some lot of night. Oh, wow. Sugarcane forest is what this is. Oh, my goodness sakes. I'm not jealous. Oh, that's really cool. You can just go along and, like, whack at him. Not that I'm going to because it's not my field, but you just, like, sit there. Although, you know, I mean, I like doing it the way I do it, but that's just because it's my thing. It's my thing. See? There's my thing. I mean, I know that people use mine, and look at this. They'll, like, take up one side, and... Oh, hold on. Wait a second. He claimed part of my sugarcane? What? Hold on now. Okay, part of my sugarcane, but not all of it. I'll forgive him. Whatever. Okay, so this... Yeah, like, people will take up part of it and then not replant. What's the deal with that? I mean, how are you supposed to get multiple things growing if you just don't replant? It's kind of like the Be Kind Rewind thing. You need to do it or you won't get the results that you desire. This is, like, kind of obnoxious. I mean, a lot of people have been doing this lately. Look at this. They'll, like, take stuff up and then they won't do anything in return. So, it's like a lack of respect, and I feel like the world needs a little bit more respect and love in it, and that is my opinion on the matter, and, you know, I don't say no to a little respect. I don't think that's an actual song. It's not like I go out of my way to sing songs that exist. Put that in your brain and mull it around for a bit. There we go. Okay. Ooh, what would this look like? I just want people to go and say, oh my gosh, Cherry, you have such a really tall sugar cane. What is that nonsense? And I'll say, really? I have a tall sugar cane? Call the Guinness Book of World Records for Minecraft. No, I wouldn't say it that obnoxiously, but I'd think about it. Can you imagine what that would look like when you... I wonder what a sugar cane that's built all the way up to top of build height would look like. I don't know. Okay, hold on. I think build height is like 242. What are we at right now? We are at 64. Which is interesting. Okay, so I'm going to get a lot of sugarcane, and then we're going to try it out, because why not? So I have a lot of sugarcane. I figure this will probably be enough to get it to the top of the height. Oh no, we need it to be next to water. I forgot. Okay, that's fine. We'll make it. It'll work. Let's do right here. So we're going to put it here, and then we're just going to keep growing it up. So, come on. All the way up. And you know it won't be able to be planted unless it's... Oh, no, I want to go all the way up. No, stop. It looks like I'm climbing a vine. Woo! All right, so I'm just going to keep going with this until we get to build height. All right, so we have reached build height. If you notice, height limit for building is 256 blocks. Apparently, that's what that is. So, although it seems more like 254, but I think that's where my feet are, but I'm not entirely certain. So, yeah. That is that. So let's go ahead and go down to the bottom and then just watch it come down. Whoa! This is great fun. Bam! All right. So first of all, let's just take a look at this nonsense. Look at that. Oh my gosh. That is one tall sugar cane. It looks almost from a distance like one of these beacon beams. I mean, look at this. Ooh, you know what? I think the beacon beams actually go up to that same height as well. Although, from this angle, it kind of looks like it goes to the... Oh, yeah. No. The exact same height. So, beacon beams will go up to build height. So, if you're ever curious about where you can build to, just plop down a beacon, and that's where it'll be. So, ooh, oh my goodness. Look at my little empire from here. Let's go ahead and get this done. Ah, free falling! Okay, so, I just really want to see this happen. Whoa! Oh, look, and it just keeps coming, like, out of nowhere. Is that it? Man, I thought it would just keep coming for a while. Like, 20 minutes later, we'd still have, yeah. Oh, well. It was fun. I enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed it, too, even though it was, like, not that long in coming. But whatever. Whatever. Okay, so we have all this sugar cane now. Why don't we just go ahead and put it over here? Because I've noticed that it looks kind of awkward along the sides here. I would really love to have some, you know... Oh, wait, I can't do that because it's way up there. Fine. Whatever. Okay, so let's put that there. And there. So basically only the ones that are long on the same level as the water will be able to do it. And that's fine, I guess. I don't know how far I put my stuff. Ooh! Oh! Okay. That was interesting. I hadn't done that before. But in retrospect, it seems like very plausible. There we are. Almost. I think most of my stuff is over here. Okay, so that's kind of cool. It'll grow up and look nice and natural. Even though it's not natural, it is in fact artificial. Okay, there. And then, Awesome sauce. All right, so we got this, the other thing. No, I don't. Okay. I don't know why I'm putting this much in, but, you know, stuff and things. Stuff and things. And there we are. Oh, this is so rad. This is so rad. Okay. My swamp is looking more swamp-like as we speak. Or I speak. I mean, you can speak as well. I don't know if you are, though, because I'm not there. Ooh, can you plant them on... You cannot plant them on clay. I was curious. Because I knew you could plant them on some sand, but I did not know about some clay. So... It was a learning thing for me, and I'm all up for learning new things. There's some things I'm like, okay, that would be new for me to learn, but I'm not going to learn it because I have no desire to learn said thing. It really depends on the thing, honestly. And then, ooh, let's just have it on the side here. It'll just be like cattails, but not cattails. It's sugarcane, which, you know, stuff. Okay. All right. Yeah. Oh my gosh. I love it. loves it. And you go there. Interesting. Okay. I'm just like putting so much sugar cane in here right now. So much sugar cane. I might not need this much sugar cane, but I mean, what is need when it comes to sugar cane? I mean, really, need. What is this need thing of which you speak, of which I speak, because I'm the one that's talking. All right, so I just think it looks really cool, honestly. And it gives it a little bit nicer look to it, because it is a swamp. I feel like it should look nice and marshy. Marshy, marshy, marshy. This is a lot of sugar cane. I'm probably going to use all of it, too. Even if I don't use it on this, I know I'll be using it on my villagers. Because what I've been doing with my villagers right now is working on my fisherman villagers. Because I want to have at least one fisherman villager with a perfect fishing rod. You know what I mean by when I say perfect fishing rod. I mean a fishing rod, the Unbreakable 3, and was it Luck of the Sea 3 and Lure 3. So yeah, that's what I mean when I say perfect fishing rod. So here's hoping. And the problem with fishermen, which I might have already mentioned, but I'm going to mention it again, is that they have the farmer villager base. And you have to continually pick them up and put them down and spawn eggs because they keep changing. You don't know if you're going to get a farmer villager or was it a butcher? No, a butcher is a different one. It was a baker. You don't know if you're going to get the baker or the fisherman or the farmer. So it could, oh no, the Fletcher. Fletcher. It's the butchers and the bakers that are the same. So yeah, you just have to keep trying until you actually get a fisherman, and then you have to trade it, hoping that the fishing pole that they get at the end of their trades is, in fact, a good fishing pole. And if it's not, then you have to pick it back up in that spawn egg using our mob capture system here in Cococraft and try it again, which may work or it may not work. Currently, it has not worked. I've just been doing two villagers back and forth, although I could do it more than two. I just haven't been because, you know, it's easier to go back and forth on something. I don't know. But, yeah, I probably don't need to do quite that much. I don't think I... Do I have this portion of it? I think I do. I think I do. I think I can just keep going around, but why? Alright, so I'm going to leave that there. That is plenty of sugar cane, honestly. Honestly. A little bit of luck. I have brought the chests away from this section of the villager tower because I was on a kick of like getting rid of chests that had really no purpose in where they were, and that happened to be one of them. So yeah, anyways, this is so noisy. Oh, we got some here, so I'll take some of this, I'll take that, and I think I might be done with this section. Hold on, put that over there, put this over here. I think I had been doing something down below here with the fishermen, or what I'm calling the fishermen, but in fact, I don't know if all of them will be, so. Because, I mean, I don't know how many perfect villagers, or perfect sugarcane villagers, no, perfect fishing, oh my gosh, can I not actually say the correct word? Right now, yeah, I'm gonna take this one, and I will take this, and then we'll see. So then we'll put that up there. I'm running low on right now. What is the reason why I haven't continued with what I was doing was that I was running out of eggs. My chickens cannot keep up with me in the lane of eggs. And that's something I never thought I would say because they laid so many. And I'm like, what? You need to slow down. So then I only put in so many chickens. That's not going to be enough. What the heck? I need one more. And that still was too much, but I have come to the conclusion that based on what I'm doing with these guys, it's not going to be enough. So I'm totally going to need more chickens in there, which, you know, is going to be noisy. I know, it's going to be so noisy, that I will live We will all live. I will turn down my audio, and it will be a beautiful thing. Keep in mind that if I turn it down and it's still obnoxious and horrendous to you guys, let me know, because I don't want you to be all miserable. Mm-mm-mm. Now, Chicken, you're over here, minding your own business, but I feel like you should be in that pen, because this pen, if you've noticed, although I'm not sure about how you feel about counting, Chicken, it only has three chickens in it. So, that is not a good number, because we need four. You know? Four. One, two, three, four. It's just the way things work. You know what? Sorry. I can't have chickens that don't count. Alright, so here we have the chickens. And this is the eggs. I mean, I kind of, like, had to slow down a little bit because, you know, I had so many eggs to begin with, and now I don't know. So, these are... I feel like this is more chickens than I remember putting in there, because I feel like I was only putting in five? There might be five in there? I don't know. That is an excellent question, but I don't know what the answer to that is. So I'm going to go ahead and throw in some more chickens in there, and then we'll just go ahead and... Alright, I'm not quite sure how many that is, but it's going to have to do because, you know, stuff and things, so... Alright, I'm going to grab these and go out and put the final chicken in that pen out there. Because, well, you know, I can't have only three chickens in that spot. Because that would be sad. Alright. Oh my goodness, that's perfect. And I will put this remaining one over here. Woo! Okay. Whee! So I haven't really been working on my museum of late, and I feel kind of guilty about it. But, you know, it is what it is. So hopefully I'll be able to fix it up in a bit. But in the meantime, the museum is put on hold. My special museum project, so... Ah, well. Perhaps later. Woo! Alright, so, cool. Now we have these lovely blocks, and I had been thinking about only putting this with scaffolding, but we've got a lot of blocks, so I figure, why not? I mean, I can always alter it later. So I think having this as the ceiling is a good thing, so maybe I should put the ceiling on first. All right. And put it that way. All right, this is working so far. I'm pretty sure the other side will be pretty easy to get to. I don't know if I want any glass to be there. I mean, it could be nice to have glass up there, but I'm not sure. Don't know if there's glass gonna be there. Alright. How has everybody's week been? I have been enjoying myself. I've also been trying to get back into learning how to write, which I stopped because... I was going through a really long phase of my life where I didn't want to do things that made me uncomfortable, and I was being lazy. I'm pretty sure a lot of people go through that. I just made it last really long time because I'm stubborn. So you should know that about me. I'm very stubborn. But yeah, I mean, that should never stop me from getting the benefit of learning new things. So that is what I'm doing. Going to be learning some new things. Because I think back when I was still living at home, I think I was like 14, and I, you know how they have those little kind of like, just fill out this test in the mail and send it in and we'll see if you are a candidate for our program kind of thing. It's mainly just for like artists and like writing, so I wrote a little story. Basically it was a description of what had happened in my life at one point. And was kind of sad, but only because it was just kids being weird and slightly mean. But anyways, not going into that because that's not the whole point of this, is I filled it out and they wrote back and said, hey, you seem like you're a good candidate for the program, which really boosted my ego. And I let that, you know, coast me through a lot of it. And they're like, okay, well, here, this is going to be your mentor. And these are the projects that you're going to be doing. And I'm like, okay, cool. And so... they set all this up, and I think I did some of them, but like so many things that I had allowed myself to just kind of like fail on, or not fail, but just stop, I just stopped doing it. And, I mean, obviously, that is like a quitter's type of mentality, because, I mean, I just, like, I don't know if I lost interest so much. I just, I'm like, I don't really want to work that hard on it, which is a really silly thing to say, and I know that it is, but that's where I have been in my life. So, I mean, I've got to admit it, so there it is. But that's where I was, and I'm slowly coming out of it. It's taking a while because, you know, by now it's become a habit, and you know how hard habits are to break. Not impossible, mind you. Oh, no, not impossible, but ridiculously hard, so you have to, like, really want it. So I am getting into that mode of really wanting it because, you know, you get to this spot and there's so much that's not happening and you're like, why am I here and everyone else I know is here? So, yeah, I mean, it's a difficult thing watching other people succeed and you're like, why am I not succeeding? Oh, right, because I'm not doing anything. Yeah. That's been me. So, I mean, if any of you are in that place right now where it's, like, really hard to get up and moving and actually doing things, I would just like to encourage you, don't give up. If things are, like, uncomfortable because they're new, and keep in mind that it has to be that reason, because there are some things that are uncomfortable for a reason, and it's not because they're new, it's because you shouldn't be doing them. They're uncomfortable because they're not meant to be done, kind of a thing. You really have to kind of, like, weigh those and decide which ones you're actually looking at that moment. But, yeah, just don't give up. I mean, weigh and measure and decide, you know what, I want to grow. And I'm not going to let my stubborn need for, you know, laziness or entertainment or whatever, because it's been the entertainment thing for me mainly, I'm not going to let it beat me. And then don't let it, because you are more than your vices or your entertainment. You can be as stubborn as you want to be. Dang it. What the heck. So I just figured I would like to encourage people in that, because it's been a really hard thing for me. And I know it seems so silly to say, because I mean, so many people have, like, started from they were really young doing all sorts of things that are, like, amazing, and it makes me feel kind of like, wow, what have I been doing with my life? But you can start at any moment, any second of every single day, and do better, do more, change it. You have that power. I have that power. And I just, like, I give myself pep talks sometimes, and I figure, hey, maybe someone else wants a pep talk, too, so this is me just helping you out with a pep talk. So, I don't know if I should actually do the floor in the emeralds. So we're going to leave that just to see. But yeah, so I hope this has encouraged you. Go ahead and leave in the comment sections below if you have been in that place, or you are in that place right now, and what you're doing to get out of it, or what would you like to do to get out of it. I mean, we can be each other's own cheering squad or what have you, because I mean, no one's totally in this alone, and it's good to have an accountability partner, someone, and by that I mean somebody who says, yeah, I know that you're working really hard to overcome such and such about the problems that you've been facing, and you know, I'm your friend, so hey, if you happen to be in such and such spot and I notice that you're doing something that you were trying to get out of doing, I'll say, hey, as your friend, just wanted to point out, don't get mad at them, because they're your accountability partner. They're the ones who are there to say that so that you can grow. And that's a good thing. Sometimes it's a hard thing to hear, especially without, like, biting someone's heads off because you really don't want to hear it, because you know that you're doing something that you don't really want to do, but you're allowing yourself to do it. So yeah, I've been thinking about that a lot lately. I know it's not, like, the most entertaining topic of conversation, but it's an important one. And I just felt the need to say it and stuff. I haven't done anything with the garden in a really long time. Like, a really long time. Oh, no. Yes. Really long time. Okay, so perhaps I need to start cordoning all this stuff off. And I could have, like, my own little village town thing here. Not that anyone else is going to live there, because I don't really hold out any compunctions about, like, people wanting to live near me. I mean, people do, obviously. I don't think about it because, to me, it seems kind of presumptuous to assume that I'm the type of person that people want to hang out with all the time. I know it may seem weird to some people to hear me say that, but it's true. That's just how I view me and my life. So, I'm just going to kind of see what things we can do. I did say I wanted to make a jail, so I totally am going to make a jail. I might end up dismantling the Prismarine picnic basket, but I haven't decided yet. Anyways, I think this is pretty much all I had really been planning on doing for this episode, because I don't want to just sit around and do a lot of villager trading with the fishermen, because I'm a grinder, and not everyone can watch a grinder grind for a while, because it's not really very interesting stuff. It just, like, you go over and over and over again, and that's pretty much it. So, anyways, I hope you have a marvelous day/week/everything, and that you have had it this last week, and I will see you all next time!